again. This is gonna be how to make a tail, like, that you can clip on, or whatever. And, damn, phone. I would like to apologize to everybody. I mean, I'd like to apologize to Hiroto-kun 3000. Hope I said that right. And, for, taking so long. It took a while to get this material, because of stuff. I accidentally cut out the material first. I mean, that's a good thing, trust me. But, in your comment, Hiroto-kun 3000, you asked if I could make it a foot and a half long. And, I forgot about that, and I already went and cut it. And it's like, it's 13 inches long, so it's like a foot and an inch. So, I'm sorry about that. It's like 2 years back, I bought a tail. See, and you clip it on. And it's very, very handy, and it's very small. And I was like, I just wanted a tiny bit bigger than that. And so I just measured it. That's like 10, and this is 13. So I didn't mean that. Sorry about that. So as you can tell, my tail is just a solid piece of fabric. And may I warn you, I use this. Very furry, super soft. This stuff is amazing soft. But it is so messy. It freaking, I made a Karibo with it. You think he's okay looking? He's super soft, so. So, I'm just saying, this is pretty hard to, like, cut, and, just it makes a big mess. So, I'm just telling you right now. But, if you want to, which is fine, what I'm going to do, I'm just showing you, and then I'll do it. I'm going to fold it in half. Like so, and I'm gonna kind of nail it off the ball. I'm gonna kind of look at it and guess what it would look like. I'm gonna go cut that out. Be sure you pin this before you cut it, preferably in the shape you want it to go in, and then cut it out. So I'm gonna go do that outside because it's messy inside. God, it's so messy. Sorry, I'm finding this stuff all over my clothes. It's getting in my mouth. But it's so soft. It's like, oh, I love this shit. It's so fluffy and warm. Make a blanket out of this, you'll be like, my material. I would kind of do like that. Like a, leave like an inch or a half inch up there. And then just kind of push it on the side. And just kind of do that with the same thing. So mine was 13 inches by 9 inches. All right, I'll be back when that's all cut out. I just did it, and I figured out two things today. First, it's best to cut it with the back, not with the hairy side. And second, it's cold out there, and I should wear some shoes instead of going around in my bare feet all the time. Okay, so. As we've seen, I've already got it done, and I decided not to keep it in the side attached because it was too far away from the side, so that was bad on my fault. But you can try it if you want. So anyways, I would suggest using the overhand stitch all the way around, except for the top, of course, so you can pull it inside out. And you should know what an overhand stitch is. I swear, you better know what an overhand stitch is, because I've said it like 5 times in all my videos. I tell you guys what an overhand stitch is. If you don't know, go look it up. I don't want to keep explaining it. Anyways, I will come back when it's all overhand stitched up. Hello. Okay. Obviously, I'm out of space because I'm really tired, even though it's only 10:27. Okay, so I finished sewing it, and I think it looks kind of good. And I stuffed it already. When you stuff it, try to make sure that the stuffing is even throughout the whole thing. And you can have it so, like, you don't even have to stuff it. Because when it's not stuffed, it's really loose. But I just stuffed it just because this one's stuffed. And it's just a habit. When I sew something like this, you stuff it. That's what I need to do. This material is, the one I used is very loose, so if in any case in yours, if you do like, I usually do 2 knots, and if you pull it through the material and it comes out, try to do a couple more knots. Or if you don't want to, which I've done a couple times, which works just fine, even did it on Karibo here, I kind of took the needle, I put it in, and I didn't pull it hard enough to like make the knot through. I just put it so it's on the very end, and then I went around and stuck my needle in it. And there's been a couple times where I've done that twice, and you yank on it and it doesn't come out. So looping it with the knot helps a lot. And I did it. Oh, also, if you notice right here, when I was sewing it, some of the fur got inside and I sewed the fur on, and that can easily be fixed by just taking a needle and pulling the thread through. I did a lot. I guess I missed a spot though. But that's how you can fix that. Or if you just don't really care, you can just not do it. Because, I mean, this fur is really, it really covers up a lot of stuff. So I'm going to make it so you can clamp it onto your pants or whatever. And I'm using an alligator clamp for that. Okay. Anyways, so I'm going to sew that. And I'm just going to do I'll just do an overhand stitch. And I'll close up as much as that. But you will also realize that this is in the way of this. So sewing it together might be a problem. But I would definitely not leave just a hole and then leave that, because it'll rip off eventually. All I did was stitch the outsides of it. Just like on this side. As long as you stitch it and it's nice and tight and it won't wiggle, I think you're good. Like, I could see some of you wanting to do like a tail with a white stripe at the end. White at the end of the tail. Like Holo from Spice and Wolf. And, just cut it out. And then when you have, like, take your material. Like, let's say you're using brown and then you want white at the bottom. Take your brown and cut it out. And then take your brown and then cut off the tip. And use that tip as like an outline, and then use that tip to cut out your white. That's the easiest way. Hair in the mouth. Okay, I'm done. Let's test drive it. Hold on. All right. As you can probably tell, these are my how to make moving cat ears. Although, since it fails to have grip, if I pull down, it will slide down.
Looks pretty good.
Well, I'm almost done. Yay, it works. Alright. That's how to make a tail. And, of course, you can do it a bunch of different ways. Like, with different clamps, different sizes, different colors, with splotches. But, that's just a very kind of basic way to do it. And, it only took me, like, 4 hours to make. And this is hand sewing, because I don't like sewing machines. I can die. So, yeah. And, if you want to know what this song was that I just played... If you don't know it, it's from Across Frontier. I've never watched it. But I know the Vocaloids do a little dance to it that they got from Across Frontier. And it's called Nyan Nyan. Not Nyan 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 Nyan. Right, anyways. Hope you liked the video, and I'll see you next time. Oh my god. I look like I have a beard. I hate cabbages. No, I hate potatoes. I hate fish. Oh, 87 years ago. I'm bored. And I'm tired as hell. School. And, Sapphire. I got a boken. You want to see my boken? Got my boken. Alright. Anyways. Oh, I'm hitting my Georges and my Spider-Man.
You know what?
I have an idea. What if I win? Hey! Stop drinking Lucy's water, cat! Kuribo, go. God, that cat. You can't leave water in this room because she keeps drinking it. I give her water. It's fine. Your water is fine, cat. What's wrong with you? Gotta go get Kuribo now. That sucks.